some case like collaborative design review, like you see in the down picture, it is very important that every person who looks at the model sees the correct perspective from his position so that they can talk about the correct things. So we need a projection of, in here, 4 people. So we need 8 picture to have 8 F4 stereo images. And it's very important, I think the most important thing is to separate these individual images. So here are some related works about research of multi-view system which are directly linked to our research. The first multi-view system was from Agrawala in 1997. He shows a 2-user system based on a CRT monitor. And since this time, there was some research about multi-view, projection-based multi-view. And the last one from Fröhlich, 2005, is, I want to show you this system. Here, it's the principal working of the work from Fröhlich from 2005. He used a multi-projector, multi-view system. This means for every view, you got an own projector. And for every projector, there was LC shutters, liquid crystal shutters. So, and they were synchronized with the shutter glasses. So the controlling by image was open and closing the shutter in same way like the shutter glasses. The disadvantage of this system is that you waste a lot of light and energy because all the projectors emit light the complete time. And we all know that the LC shutters do not complete the darken the image. So we got a lot of crosstalk from every dark projector, and this crosstalk will be added by the number of users. You also got heat problems because the shutters are directly in front of the projector and you have to actively cool them. And LC shutters attenuate brightness in the open state, so you lost a lot of light to this tube LC shutters the light is going through. And from this system, I would introduce you our system, our LED LC-based system. Here, you see, for projectors, these are from Samsung, the SPFM10 LED LCD projectors. These projectors got a brightness of 1,000 ansilumen. In this optical path, it's a 3-chip LCD with red, green, and blue LED. And what we do, we modify these projectors. We shutter the light source. So we separate the different images by shuttering the light source. So we don't need shutters in front of the projectors. And when you cut off the light source, so it's really dark. So in running system, only one projector emits light, all the other projectors are complete dark. So this reduces the left and right crosstalk induced by the projectors nearly to zero, and you can use only from the projectors. And you can, and using LEDs is the best thing for this system because you can switch them in high frequency. The on and off switching is less than 1 microsecond. So how do we modify these projectors? We separate the LEDs. You can see here the LEDs. We separate the LEDs from the internal power supply, put a high power MOSFET inside with a driver. It works like an electronical switch. And we can control the light source with the timings of the light source, with an Atmel microcontroller, with a wireless Zigbee communication protocol. And for a system like this, we need special shutter glasses, because normal shutter glasses are not able to work in a achromatic, in a not we have a lot of slots, and so we need special shutter classes to run in high frequency and to separate the different views. So what we done, we use a stack combination of two liquid crystal cells. We put a normally black and a normally white cell together. So we combine the both advantages of both shutters. This is the fast on switching of the normally black cell and the fast off switching of the normally white cell. You see here in the diagram, with this combination, we can produce very short pulses of light. So if you have more views, you can really good separate the different views with this combination. The synchronizing between the shutters and the projectors also is done by a Zigbee-based radio frequency protocol and an Atmel microcontroller. And what's really cool at the system is we can program the timings at runtime. So in every condition, we can move the timings, we can do something like you move your head and the glasses get out and you see it not flickering at the side. So we can, all the timings we can move at runtime. So here you see the system in working with two users. On the right side, you see the custom-made mounting rack we built because it's a low-cost consumer product, this projector. And it's really hard to get the images together. We have to mount it with a rack like this. So now, I have a look on the image quality of the system. I look on brightness and crosstalk. Yesterday in session number 8, Mr. Stefani shows you a way to calculate and to measure a multi-view projection-based system, and we use the same measurement method like here. We have three measurement requirements. The first one is the signal. This means that the signal you see, the attenuated light at the eyes is white. All the other images are black. Then we get the maximum crosstalk. This means the light, the your slot that you are for your eye is black, and all the unintended images are white. And to get rid of the ambient lighting, you need a measurement of all black levels from the system. And then you get a formula to calculate the crosstalk of the system. So here's the measurement for the LC-based system. I want to say something about LC projectors. We know that in the projection way, or in the internal of the projector from an LC system, we got reflections of the different colors. So the output light of an LC-based projector has different polarization areas. So the green light is 90 degrees rotated to red and blue. So if this light from the projector goes through a normal shutter glasses, it's the same effect, nearly the same effect like unpolarized lights to an LC shutter. You have a lot of losses. Practically, it's maybe about 70 to 80%. So in the normal running system, we measured 11.25 candela per square meters at the eye. And here we got an overall crosstalk from 1.8%. It also really looks good. You can see only a minimal crosstalk in the system like running like this. So we optimized the system with a low loss filter. This is a combination of a color selective half wave retarder plate and an achromatic quarter wave retarder. So what's done there? The color selective retarder rotates the green light so that the light out of the projector is parallel, and the achromatic quarter wave retarder produces circular polarization. So we can use this system in different conditions. The first one is we can separate the images by time multiplexing, by shuttering. The second one is we can separate the user's eye with circular polarization, and we can combine this together, so we separate the eyes with polarization and shuttering together. And in this condition, the luminancy increases to 60.39 candela per square meter, which is an improvement of about 45.7% to the first one. And the overall crosstalk is going down to 0.62%, what's an improvement of 68.8%. And in this system, running like this, you, with your eyes, you can't see any kind of crosstalk. Another optimization is to increase only the brightness, is to double the open time of the shutters and separate the user's eye with polarization. And the user's separation is done by time multiplexing. So the luminancy increases really high to 37.4 candela per square meter, but the overall crosstalk is getting worse. But it's no problem. Under 4% is always good for a system like this. So let me conclude our work. We have produced a multi-view system based on commodity projectors, low-cost projectors, done by pulsing the LED light source. We got much more better light and energy efficiency than in the shutter-based system. We reduced the increasing of crosstalk with a number of views, and we reduced the overall crosstalk by a factor of 2. Using this low-loss filters increases the brightness and reduces the crosstalk. And for future work, we hope that in future we get some LED-based projectors with a lot of more brightness, and we hope that we get some 120 Hz projector so that we can halve the number of projector and make a very compact system. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kors. Question or comments? Please. Please tell your name and affiliation.
Since the LEDs are off most of the time, you should, I would imagine, in principle, be able to run them at higher instantaneous current levels. I mean, typically the power dissipation of the LED is based on its average power. So I was wondering if you consider pulsing them at even higher currents than they operate in the steady state and therefore get considerably more light out.
The current is, the power supply is from the projector. So we got a little bit losses from the longer electronic lines from the projector to the LED. So we have a little bit losses from the ohms resistance. But the current is the same. This is a high current LED from, what this was your question, or? Yeah, we have checked this. We have checked that when we, in normal time, the LED is glowing the whole time. And when we pulse these LEDs, we can drive this with higher current. But it's a problem, the efficiency of the LED goes down. So by with higher current, you got more less lumen per watt. And when one time I damaged one LED by too much current, it blows.
Any other questions or comments? Okay. So, thank you.